Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Hallelujah. Glory. Hasn't God done an amazing job in bringing you through 2020? One. Hallelujah. The most important thing, I believe the Holy Spirit wants us to experience today, is a heart of thanksgiving. Not the words, but the heart. This is our most important service of the year. And as I will share in a few moments, you will see clearly that thanksgiving is so important to God. That's all he really gets for all he does. A heartfelt thank you. What can you give to God? He owns
everything,
including you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, I felt him when I told you that. Your greatest thank you is you giving you to him. Hallelujah. You lifting your hands and looking up to heaven. I know heaven is everywhere you stand. But you can say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for being God in my life. Thank you for granting me salvation. Thank you for filling me with your Holy Spirit. Thank you for putting my name in your book. Hallelujah. Thank you that I can die right now and I'm not afraid of going to hell. Thank you, Lord, that you not only have loved me now, you will love me eternally. Hallelujah. Come on, bless him. Bless him. Hallelujah. He's all we have. He's all we have. He's our strength. He's our glory. He is the lifter up of our head. Hallelujah. Glory, yeah, we magnify your name,
glorify your name,
oh God,
oh God,
we magnify
your name.
The communication with God is in my spirit. Amen. But when we were shouting, I said, come on, what came to me is, let's make the demons of football jealous. Yeah. Huh? They're shouting their heads off because of a pigskin. But we have a king on the throne. We have better reasons to shout and to give him praise. Glory! Thank you, Lord! We give you praise! I'm just hearing things from him that I didn't even hear when I was preparing for service.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because a moment ago, I told you that we should thank him that we have God in our lives and that we belong to him. And he just put in my spirit, you see, this God thing, having God, is not a light matter. Because the Bible says that the Father said to Jesus, you will be my son, but I will be God to you. Hey.
Hallelujah.
If the Lord Jesus needed him to be God, hallelujah, you ought to celebrate that you have God in your life. Hallelujah. The God factor. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Years ago, I said that we belong to God, that he created us for himself. And I touched off all this anger from these religious devils. And this young man said to me, oh, so what does that mean? We are just his robots and he just... I said, oh, look at this ignoramus. I said, yes, if you think you're a robot, but he gave you a will.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. No, he created us for his own pleasure.
Yes.
He can dispense with us if he chooses to. And there's nothing you can do. That's what I keep telling people. That's God. That's why you worship him as God. That's why you praise him as God. He's not a man. There's no debate here. The only solution is you surrender to God.
Hallelujah.
I want you to consider this. I shared it with you before. God said to me, son, I want to teach you the fear of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I said, okay, go ahead, sir. He said, now, if I just decided that you will go to hell, he said, do you know you will go? He said, you can hate me. You can curse me out. You can be screaming at me. But guess what? You will go. Uh-huh. Now, you see, on earth, you have the Supreme Court. You have the one for the state. Then you can appeal to the one in D.C.
Yes.
For the nation. And then when they give their final ruling, then you don't have any other recourse. If they say you're going to the electric chair, you're going.
Amen.
That just gives you a little idea of what I'm trying to explain to you. But you will understand your shout in a minute. Watch. God is the final arbiter in heaven
and on earth.
And on earth.
Hallelujah.
His counsel stands.
Amen.
Hey, hallelujah. You're going to get it in a minute. This is the highest of the highest. Even though it looks like it's a negative thing, I'm telling you, no, it's a positive thing. Why is it a positive thing that this God that can decide that you will go to hell now and nobody can stop him and there's nothing you can do to change it, decided to love you? I don't know why some of you are not shouting. He told me to do this and then to move on after that. Now watch. I said some of you are not shouting. See, because we don't understand that when we go into life and warfare is raging and Satan is attacking, you begin to act as if God is not in your life because you don't understand the concept of God. That's why the writer of Romans, Paul, says, if God be for us, if God is over here, who can be you understand what I'm talking about. Your faith ought to rise. The God is on my side. And the devil has his plea, has his say. This is not religion, beloved. This is praise with understanding. You should be celebrating when you come to this altar today. The first thing you thank him about, thank you, Lord, for choosing me. Jesus says, you didn't choose me, I chose you. Hey. Hey, glory to God. I am God's choice. I am God's blessing. To God. That's what Thanksgiving is all about, is appreciating what you have already received, not what you are trying to get. Because many times we've received so much, yet we are still hungry for so much. But come to this altar today and thank him from your heart. Thank him. And honor him with the right gift. Don't come here and offend him. Come here and honor him. Why will I make that comment? I haven't said that in the other Thanksgiving services because I was getting ready for church. He said, now, go warn the people. Some of them are coming to my altar with the wrong gift. See, he already knows what you planned. God. How does he know that? He gave you everything. And when you are counting off your money, he was counting with you. His spirit is everywhere. He knows when you lie. And then he tells you, now, you know, you just told a lie. That's how we know you are saved. Because once you lie, your countenance falls. Sinners lie with a straight face. They pass the lie detector test. But a believer, you can't control it because God is in you. Telling you, you lie. Now tell the truth and trust me. Hallelujah. Ooh, come on. Lift your hands and celebrate that you have God in your life. God. Not a figment of your imagination. The creator of the ends of the earth. God. The God of all creation. Hallelujah. In Psalm 100 that we are familiar with, and it's been read so many times, verse 4 says, enter into his gates and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth all generations. Amen. Yes, hallelujah. I mean, we can talk about it later, but the word he gave to me for this service was the force of thanksgiving. And I mentioned earlier on that it is not the word spoken, but the heart. That is why it is such a fight in our lives. Murmuring and complaining is automatic with us. Now, of all the judgments, as I've shown you before, in the scriptures, you know, whether it was fornication or any of these things that God judged Israel on, he removed the consequences by intercession, but not for murmuring and complaining. He left that curse there permanently. And he says now, when you murmur, you're going to get bitten by a snake. But if you look on the snake, on the cross, you will be healed. You see? Why? Because thanksgiving, a heart of thanksgiving, is your greatest offering. Now watch. If you had a large check this morning to give to God, If you gave it, you will feel that something has left you. Am I right? That's what a sacrifice of thanksgiving is. Even when things are not working, if you can find it to say thank you, you will feel virtue. That's why it's called a sacrifice of thanksgiving. But it delivers you from Satan. It communicates to heaven that God owns you and that you will not tolerate any satanic accusation against God in your life. Whether things are working or not, God is God. Hallelujah. In Him is no darkness at all. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let Him be honored in this house. Let our hearts be true in this house. He will do more, exceeding abundantly, above all we can ask or think. Hallelujah. That no matter what life is dishing out, we hold God in honor. Hallelujah. We worship Him. We are not undertake. We are not harlots. We love Him. We worship Him. One other quick thing. Have mercy. He says, enter into His gates. Watch. If I can find this heart of thanksgiving and offer it, it will bring me into a realm. Watch now. Jesus said, I want to use a negative to show you the positive. Jesus says, I will build my church. He said, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. What does that tell you? That the gates is the place where they strategize. The inner sanctum where they conceive their wickedness and their evil against you and I. And the Bible says, if I can find, you see, you will not have a satanic gate if it's not an imitation of the real gate. Are you hearing what I'm teaching you? He says that now when God finds thanksgiving in my heart, I will be brought into the realm of God where decisions are made, where the power comes from, where the covenants are released, that no matter what happens, God will stand up for you. He said, enter His gates with thanksgiving, hallelujah, and His courts with praise. If you want to push into the realm of God, you better come with a thank you today. If you want to see, hallelujah. Hey! Glory! Hey! My, yeah! Glory to God! I want to enter them gates! Hallelujah! Colossians 4. Masters, give unto your servants that which is just and equal, knowing that you also have a master in heaven. Watch. Continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. Watch. You see, Jesus said, watch and pray. You see, it came out in the testimony. I don't know if it's Brandon or LeGrand. That I've been teaching you to be God watchers. You see, watch. He says, okay, watch. Petition prayer particularly, there's always a lag between the time you pray before you see a manifestation. That's why Jesus says, whatsoever things you, when you pray, believe that you receive and you shall. You notice the lag? You say, when you pray, believe that you receive, right here, and you shall. So what is the mystery? You say, continue in prayer and watch. So as soon as I pray, I believe I receive. And then I start looking for the answer. How do I shop around my answer to reach me? I start thanking God for it. While I'm thanking God, I'm looking for it. I don't go around saying it hasn't happened. No, I believe it has happened. And I start thanking God for it. And I'm looking for it. hey, is this the one? Thank you, Lord. Is this my answer? Is it? Hey, so that there is no room for Satan to get his legs in, because I believe and I'm watering my belief with. Hallelujah. It's the force. You protect your prayers from satanic attacks. That's what I wanted you to see from these two testimonies. That at this level of glory, expect Satan to come himself to resist you, to oppose you. You cannot be faint-hearted. Hallelujah. And even after you prayed and you worshiped and you are thanking God and they're still hanging on you, carry them with you. Bring them with you to church. Before church is over, the glory will run them gremlins off of you. Hallelujah. That's what faith is about. Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. So Lord, we give you praise. Thank you for helping us come family by family. The altar is raised on the altar. The glory is ready. May your people come accurately to worship, to thank you. Let miracles happen here. We celebrate you, for you are God, and we are looking for no other. We desire no other. We are complete in you, and we are satisfied with your care of us. Receive all the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Happy Thanksgiving. Your heart ought to be filled with gratitude this morning for all that the Lord your God has done for you this year, done in you this year, and what he has done through you this year. The three faces of Thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now, did you get those bullets from the few minutes I shared in this Thanksgiving service? Your heart is everything. That if the thank you coming from your mouth is actually from your heart, you will find the gates of glory, the gates of power, the gates of miracles, where decisions are made. We were in one of our Gloryful USA trips, and the Holy Spirit said to give thanks. We were so exhausted and tired. And as soon as we started giving thanks, strength came. But all of a sudden, I saw all these convergence of light. It is like in the, I don't know, massive amounts, all converging to one slot, one gate. And the Holy Spirit said to me, the gates of God is in the millions, but they all converge to one spot. That wherever thanksgiving is offered, the gate appears. Your own channel into God, and we all converge into one. Isn't that amazing? Other than that, you have all these false altars in the billions all over the earth, going nowhere. But through the Lord Jesus, through a true heart of thanksgiving, we can all be 6 million of us worshiping at the same time. And those beams of light will converge into one, and we enter one gate. Amen. God has windows. God has gates. The Bible tells you that I will enter his gates with thanksgiving. So sometimes prayer and intercession will bring you into a gate. Thanksgiving brings you into a gate. Sometimes it's forgiveness that brings you into a gate. Sometimes it's worship. Sometimes it's a gift you give to God, and the gates open unto you. Everything with God is a heart. It's time for revival to begin among church people. It cannot be the routine of holidays and football and cranberry sauce and all the goodies that we eat during this season. God is ready. Miracles are happening. when our hearts are right with him. He's ready to bless. He's ready to encourage, to heal, to deliver. As I was saying that, I just saw a family situation. It could be so many, but at least one. Every time you guys get together, it's chaos. But yet you love each other and you can't help but get together. At least other people, this is how you know it's you I'm talking about. Other people, due to the chaos, will not want to get together. But you guys have chaos, but you keep getting together. It's because the Lord is in the midst of you. And he's asking you all to humble yourself so you can hear each other. And you will resolve what the issue is and drive that devil out. Ooh, look at this. He just said to me, it's because your family is destined for greatness. That's what Satan is fighting. God wants to use you all to get some things done on the earth. Receive your word today and be delivered in Jesus' name. God bless you. I gotta go. We love you.